我们现在要开始我们下午安息日的聚会。
We're about to begin our afternoon service.
我们低头来默祷。
Let's bow our heads and pray in silence.
阿们。
Amen.
奉主耶稣的圣名，我们开始下午的聚会。
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we begin our afternoon service.
唱诗453首。
Let us sing hymn number 453.
愿大家平安。
May peace be with all of you.
我们最近西北区读经的进度是创世纪。
Recently, for our Northwest region, our Bible reading schedule is on Genesis.
创世纪从12章到50章，在描写四个人。
From chapter 12 to chapter 50, it describes the life of four people.
就是亚伯兰、以撒、雅各跟约瑟。
Which is Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph.
那这四个人都是有信心的。
And these are people of faith.
所以他们信仰的旅程是我们的一个榜样。
And so their journey of faith is an exemplar for all of us.
那在这个世代的人当中，他们共同有一个观念，就是寄居。
And in this four generation of people, they have a common idea, which is that they are sojourners.
所谓寄居，就是做客人。
And that they are travelers, they're sojourners.
这表示说他们有原来住的地方。
That means the place that they originally live.
后来他们离开了那个地方，到另外一个地方去做客人。
They left that hometown and went to another place as travelers.
亚伯兰有两个故乡。
Abraham had two hometowns.
一个是他肉身所出来的地方，就是乌尔。
And the first one is his bodily hometown, which was Ur.
神要叫他离开他的故乡，到应许之地迦南地寄居。
God called him out from Ur, called him to land of Canaan to live.
但是后来他到了迦南地以后，他向往更美的家乡。
And after he arrived at Canaan, there was a place that he longed for.
是天上的，是神所经营、神所建造的。
It was a place of heaven that was governed and managed by God.
所以在他人生的后半，所谓寄居，就是他想要回天上的家乡。
So in the latter half of his life, he was a sojourner, longing to go back to that hometown.
那后来到他的儿子以撒。And
later on, his son Isaac.
以撒也想要搬家。Isaac
also wanted to move.
因为遇到饥荒。Because
there was a famine where he lived.
他想要搬到埃及去寄居。He
wanted to move down to Egypt.
但是神说你不要下埃及。But
God told him not to move down to Egypt.
你要住在这里。God
wanted him to stay put.
结果这个饥荒带给他很丰盛的体验。And
in that famine, he received a lot of blessings.
对神的恩典，对神的应许有很真实的体验。He
had a lot of experience of God's blessing and grace.
所以我们不论住哪里，最重要就是我们要有很清楚。 神的指示跟神的带领。So
it doesn't matter where we live, we have to have a clear understanding of God's will and His guidance.
那以撒有两个儿子，一个是以扫，一个是雅各。Isaac
had two sons, one is Jacob, and another one Esau.
那今天我们要来查考雅各。And
today we're going to learn about the life of Jacob.
雅各的一生。 也是过着寄居的生活。
Jacob also lived a life as a sojourner.
那如果我们看创世纪，我们可以看到雅各一生住过至少三个地方。
And if we look at Book of Genesis, we can learn that Jacob lived in at least three places.
当然，他原来就是出生在迦南地。
He was born in the land of Canaan.
我们如果看创世纪二十八章。
Genesis chapter 28.
创世纪的二十八章。
Genesis chapter 28.
二十八章的第三节。
Genesis chapter 28, verse 3.
还有第四节请读。
And verse 3, may God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and multiply you, that you may be an assembly of peoples. Verse 4, and give you the blessing of Abraham to you and your descendants with you, that you may inherit the land in which you are a stranger, which God gave to Abraham.
这个地方以撒对雅各说
Here, Isaac told Jacob,
将神将应许亚伯兰赐福给你跟你后裔，使你承受你所寄居之地。
And give you the blessing of Abraham to you and your descendants with you, that you may inherit the land in which you are a stranger.
就是神赐给亚伯兰的。
Which God gave to Abraham.
这个就是迦南地。
And this was the land of Canaan.
也是以撒所寄居的地方。
It was also a place where Isaac lived as a stranger.
那以撒就从迦南地搬到哈兰。
Isaac moved from there to Padam Aram.
那为什么以撒需要搬家？
And why did Isaac move?
如果我们看二十七章。
If we turn to chapter 27.
二十七章的四十三节。
Chapter 27, verse 43.
创世纪二十七章的四十三节。
Chapter 27, verse 43. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice, arise, flee to my brother, Laban from Haran.
这个地方就是他的妈妈对他建议。
And here, Jacob's mother told him this.
说你要听我的话，起来，逃往哈兰，我哥哥拉班他，拉班那里去。
Saying, my son, obey my voice, arise, flee to my brother, Laban in Haran.
所以三十四节，同他住一些日子，等到你哥哥的怒气消退了。
And to live there until your brother's fury turns away.
所以以撒为什么要搬，雅各为什么要搬家？
So why did Jacob need to move?
因为他的哥哥想要杀他。
Because his brother wanted to kill him.
所以他没有办法住下来，他要照着妈妈的建议到哈兰去住一段时间。
That's why he could not remain where he was and he had to flee away.
在哈兰寄居。
And live in Haran.
什么？他要到哈兰去寄居。
And why did he need to move to Haran and live there as a stranger?
很显然，如果我们读前后的故事这个不是神原来对他的计划。
If we look at the story before and after this, we understand this was not God's original plan for him.
那是因为雅各用计谋骗取他爸爸的祝福，长子名分的祝福。
Rather, this was because Jacob used a deceitful tactic to steal his brother's blessing.
当然雅各他的名字就是抓住。他真的很有信心，他想要抓住最宝贵的。
And Jacob's name was meaning grab, and he really wanted to grab onto his blessings.
他的哥哥以撒为着一碗红豆汤把长子的名分出卖给他。
And his brother Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of lentil soup.
为着短暂肉体的满足把更大的福分卖掉。
Esau forsook the better blessing for a short-term gain.
雅各抓住这个机会他要得长子的名分。
And Jacob, grabbing hold of this opportunity, he acquired the birthright.
我们回来看创世纪二十八章。
Let's turn back to Genesis chapter 28.
创世纪二十八章。
Genesis chapter 28.
第十节。
Verse 10.Now Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran.
11节.
Verse 11. So he came to a certain place and stayed there all night because the sun had set, and he took one of the stones of that place and put it at his head, and he lay down in that place to sleep.
13节.
Verse 13. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I'm the Lord your God.The Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac, the land on which you lie, I give to you in your
sleep.
Verse 14, also your descendants shall be as the dust of the earth. You shall spread abroad to the west and the east, to the north and the south, and in you and in your seed, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Verse 15, Behold, I am with you and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you.
16.
Verse 16, Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it.
17.
Verse 17, and he was afraid and said, How awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
第十节说雅各离开别示巴往哈兰去。
Verse 10 says that Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran.
他现在要去到一个没有去过的地方寄居。
And now he's going to a place where he has never been before to dwell there.
离开他所爱的家庭母亲。
He's leaving his hometown, his family, and his mother.
前面要遇到什么事情呢？他也不知道。
And he doesn't know what he will face.
什么时候要回来？他也不知道。
He also doesn't know when he gets to go back.
所以前面的路真的他不知道，也没有办法把握。
There's a lot of uncertainty. He doesn't know what lies ahead of him.
所以他就在那里拿了一块石头，就在那里睡觉。
So he just took a stone from that place and lay down to sleep.
有时候我们的人生真的遇到很多变化，我们没有办法掌控。
And sometimes in our lives, there's a lot of things that we cannot control.
我们不晓得前面要怎么变化。
And we don't know what lies ahead of us.
有时候我们会觉得很失望。
Sometimes we would feel discouraged.
但是在这个时刻神在梦中向他显现。
But at this point in time, God appeared to him in his dream.
所以很显然神并没有忘记他。
So from this, we can tell that God did not forget him.
神并没有放弃他。
God did not give up on him.
神跟亚伯兰立约。
God making a covenant with Jacob.
神现在要跟他立约。
God made a covenant with Abraham, and now God is making a covenant with Jacob.
所以十三节说，我是你主亚伯兰的神，也是以撒的神。
So in verse 13, God told him that I am the Lord God of Abraham, your father.
那接下去我要帮你现在所躺卧之地赐给你跟你的后裔。
in that the land on which you lie, I will give to you and your descendants.
哦，所以在这个神的应许里面，神就变成的啊，雅各的神。
And in this promise, God become the God of Jacob.
哦，所以十四节，你的后裔要地上的尘土那么多，万国要因你的后裔得福。
And God also promised him that his descendants shall be numerous as the dust.
啊，十五节非常宝贵，我要跟你同在。
And in verse 15, God says, I am with you and will be with you wherever you go.
所以我们一生不晓得要去过几个地方，不晓得要在哪里寄居。
And in our lives, we don't know how many places we will go to and don't know where we will go.
但是如果神跟我们同在，
But if God abides with us,
啊，我们就没有害怕。
Then we don't need to be afraid.
啊，所以十五节下面说，你无论往哪里去，我要保佑你。
And so in the latter part of verse 15, saying that, wherever you go, I will be with you, will keep you wherever you go.
那最后我要领你归回这个地，我不离弃你。
For I and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you.
啊，所以在啊雅各到拉班的家之前呢，神给他这个应许。啊，确实对他往前面的道路是一个很大的帮助。
So before Jacob arrived at the house of Laban, God already gave him this promise, and this promise gives him a lot of help in his heart.
啊，所以他的哥哥啊，以扫想要杀他，但是在神的眼中啊，神对他的爱并没有改变。
Even though his brother Esau wanted to kill him, but the love of God for him did not change.
啊，所以有时候我们虽然做了一些错误，但是哦，啊，神对我们的爱是没有改变，神是不轻易发怒。
We should say that even though sometimes we sin and we make a mistake, God's love for us is still the same, because God is not easy to anger.
啊，那我们在受洗的时候跟神立的约，神还是会继续承受。承诺继续遵守他跟我们所立的约。
And the covenant we've made with God when we were baptized, this covenant stands.
啊，所以我们在最失望的时候，还要回想啊，我们所拜的天父是跟我们同在的。
And so when we're at a point where we're very discouraged, we should remember that God is still with us.
啊，然后雅各就继续他的前面的路程。
So Jacob continued on his journey.
所以二十九章开始啊，雅各就到拉班的家。
And starting from chapter 29, he arrived at Laban's house.
哦，这个就是神要他学习功课的地方。
And this was a place where God wanted him to learn.
哦，如果我们看到结论
，If we look at the conclusion,
啊，就是啊。神真的在雅各受苦当中带领他、引导他、祝福他。
We can see that God really helped him and blessed him through his trials and difficulties.
哦，在二十九章里面开始啊，就记载他为着娶太太啊、哦、拉结，他做了十四年的苦工。
And in chapter 29, we can see that Jacob toiled and labored for 14 years in order to marry Rachel.
哦，就是因为啊，拉班啊，让他受的苦。
And this was a difficulty laid upon him by Laban.
啊，但是啊，哦，在这个苦难当中啊，哦，神祝福他。
But in this difficult time of difficulty, God blessed him.
我们看创世纪三十章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter
30. 二十七节。
Verse
27.
And Laban said to him, Please say, if I have found favor in your eyes, for I have learned by experience that Lord has blessed me for your sake.
所以在这个呀，拉班也看出来啊。神赐福于我是因为你的缘故，所以雅各到拉班的家，拉班得福。
And even Laban could see that God blessed him, his household, and for the sake of Jacob.
主要不是因为拉班本身，是因为神与雅各同在。
And he was, Laban was blessed not because of himself, but rather because God was with Jacob.
所以我们的一生，有时候，在受苦当中，只要神跟我们同在，我们就不怕。
So even in times of difficulties, if God is with us, then we don't need to be afraid.
所以连拉班也承认，因为雅各神祝福他。
And Laban, even Laban acknowledged that because of Jacob, God blessed them.
那我们现在看31章。
Let's turn to chapter 31.
创世纪的31章。
Genesis chapter 31.
我看第三节。
Let's look at verse 3. Then the Lord said to Jacob, Return to the land of your fathers and to your family, and I will be with you.
这个第三节神对雅各说，你要回到你列祖之地，就是迦南地。
And in verse 3 here,The Lord said to Jacob, Return to the land of your fathers, which is the land of Canaan.
就是我必与你同在。
And God also says, I will be with you.
所以他在拉班的家做客旅、做寄居的时间结束了。
So the time living as a sojourner, as a stranger in Laban's house has ended.
那这个到底告诉我们什么
？So what does this tell us？
我们来看罗马书。
Let's turn to the book of Romans。
罗马书第五章。
The book of Romans, chapter 5。
罗马书第五章的第三节。
Chapter 5, verse 3。
请。
And not only that, but we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance.
第四节。
Verse 4, and perseverance, character, and character, hope.
第五节。
Verse 5, now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us.
这里说患难中也是欢欢喜喜的。
And here it says that in tribulation, we glory in tribulations.
那接下去就是患难对我们是有好处的。
And that tribulations benefits us.
第四节，第三节，患难生忍耐，忍耐生老练。
Tribulation produces perseverance and perseverance character.
英文叫做 character, 再翻回来就是个性。这个患难到最后就是要改变我们的个性。
And in the end, the tribulations will change our character.
但是这个受苦不是永远的，所以老练生盼望。
But this tribulation is not forever. It ends at some point, so there is a hope.
那第五节，圣灵把神的爱浇灌在我们心里。
In verse 5, God has poured down Holy Spirit in our heart.
我说原来这个是出于神的。
This is out of God's love.
因此我们在人生遇到困难。
Therefore, when we're faced with tribulations,
神爱我们没有改变。
God's love for us has not changed.
特别是当我们祷告被圣灵充满，神将他的爱浇灌在我们心里。
Especially when we are praying with the fullness of Holy Spirit, God's love will be poured down on us.
那我们就知道，我们前面一定会有一条出路。
And we will have this hope, knowing that there will be a way for us.
因为患难到最后就是盼望。
Because the end result of tribulations is hope.
所以雅各在拉班的家时间到了，神就叫他回去。
So when Jacob has finished his time at Laban's house, God called him out.
那他就回来到迦南地去。
And so he returned to the land of Canaan.
他回到迦南以后，一件大事情改变了。
When he returned to the land of Canaan, there was a big incident that happened.
我们看创世纪三十二章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 32.
二十七节。
Verse 27. So he said to him, "What is your name?" He said, "Jacob."
二十八节。
Verse 28.And he said, "Your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have struggled with God and with men and have prevailed."
这里说你不要再叫雅各。
Here it says, "Your name shall no longer be called Jacob."
雅各是抓住的意思。
Jacob means to grab hold of.
你要叫以色列。
Rather, his name shall be called Israel.
以色列就是神的王子。
Israel means prince with God.
这是非常尊贵的一个身份。
It's a very precious and honorable status.
所以他回到迦南地，神就改变他的名字，叫做神的王子，叫以色列。
And when he returned to the land of Canaan, God changed his name to be calledPrince with God.
所以今天我们在地上是做客旅、做寄居的。
So today, when we're living here, we are sojourners, we're strangers in this land.
虽然真的是在世界上算不了什么。
Even though on earth it doesn't mean much.
但是在神的眼中我们是神的王子。
Even though we're not worth a lot on this earth, but in the eyes of God, we are prince of God.
我们要承受这个王所赐给我们那一块牛奶与蜜之地。
We are to receive the land of flowing that's flowing with milk and honey from God.
那个就是主耶稣说天国近他所带来给我们的天国。
And this is what Jesus said when he said, "The heaven is near." That this is heaven.
那天国就是神的国。
Heaven is the kingdom of God.
既然有国，就是有王。
And since it's a kingdom, there's a king.
那个王就是我们所拜的独一真神。
And this king is the only true God whom we worship.
那我们就是这一个王的王子。
And we're the prince of this king.
所以我们就是要来承受神为我们预备这个神的国。
And so we ought to receive this kingdom that God has prepared for us.
因此我们天上的客旅我们是天上的国民，在地上做客人，做寄居。
So we're citizens of heaven and we are strangers on earth.
因此我们最后要回到神为我们应许那永远的国度。
In the very end, we ought to return to heaven, to the eternal kingdom.
那雅各回到迦南以后他又再搬家。
So after Jacob returned to Canaan, he moved once again.
就是搬到埃及。
He moved down to Egypt.
这个是在他年纪大的时候发生的。
This happened when he was old.
好，我们看四十六章。
Let's turn to the book of Genesis, chapter 46.
创世纪的四十六章。
Chapter 46.
第一节。
Verse 1. So Israel took his journey with all that he had and came to Beersheba and offered sacrifices to the God of his father Isaac.
第二节。
Verse 2, then God spoke to Israel in the vision of the night and said, "Jacob, Jacob," and he said, "Here I am."
第三节。
Verse 3, so he said, "I am God, the God of your father. Do not fear to go down to Egypt, for I will make of you a great nation there."
第四节。
Verse 4, I will go down with you to Egypt, and I will also surely bring you up again, and Joseph will put his hand on your eyes.
第五节。
Verse 5, then Jacob arose from Beersheba, and the sons of Israel carried their father Jacob, their little ones, and their wives, in the carts which Pharaoh had sent to carry him.
所以从第五节雅各就下到埃及去了。
So in verse 5, he went down to Egypt.
但是在到埃及之前呢，神又应许他。
But before he went down to Egypt, God made a promise to him.
我是你父亲的神。
Saying that I'm the God of your father.
也是你的神。
I'm your God.
你下埃及不要怕，我要在那里使你成为大族。
Do not fear to go down to Egypt, for I will make of you a great nation there.
那第四节我要必定把你带上来，带回来。
And I will go down with you to Egypt, and I will also surely bring you up again.
所以神应许他在埃及虽然是寄居的，神要同在，神要赐福，神要带他回来。
So God promised him that even though he will temporarily dwell in Egypt, God will be with him, and that God will also bring him back.
那如果我们到了四十七章，我们就看到。雅各虽然年纪很大，但是这个寄居的观念呢没有改变。
In chapter 47, we can see that even though Jacob was already very old, his idea about him being a stranger on this land did not change.
我们看第八节。
Let's turn to verse 8.
创世纪四十七章第八节。
Genesis chapter 47, verse 8. Pharaoh said to Jacob, "How old are you?"
第九节。
Verse 9, and Jacob said, Pharaoh, the days of the years of my pilgrimage are 130 years. Few and evil have been the years of my life, and they have not attained to the days of the years of the life of my fathers in the days of pilgrimage.
第九节一节两次里面呢，他讲两次，我寄居在世的年子130岁。
And in verse 9, here he mentioned the word pilgrimage two times, and he mentioned his pilgrimage was 130 years.
那接下去是不及我列祖在世寄居的日子。
And that they have not attained the days of the years of life of his fathers.
那后来雅各在埃及地住了17年。
And later on, Jacob lived in the land of Egypt for 17 years.
所以28节他147岁死了。
So in verse 27, he lived there for 147 years in total.
我们就想我们人在年纪大的时候最关心是什么？
And when we are old, what's the most important things to us?
这个完全看我们跟神的关系是怎么样。
And this depends upon our relationship with God.
所以雅各在140岁要临死之前，他吩咐什么？
And when Jacob was about to die at 140 years old, what did he tell his descendants?
29节。
Let's look at verse 29.When the time drew near that Israel must die, he called his son Joseph and said to him, Now if I have found favor in your sight, please put your hand under my thigh and deal kindly and truthfully with me. Please do not bury me in Egypt. 30. But let me lie with my fathers. You shall carry me out of Egypt and bury me in their burial place. And he said, I will do as you have said.
最后的吩咐就是不要把我葬在埃及。
His last direction for for Joseph was, please do not bury me in Egypt.
因为埃及是寄居之地。
Because he's only a stranger there.
然后要把我带出埃及，葬在他的列祖所葬的地方，那是应许之地。
But carry me out of Egypt and bury me in my with my fathers.
Burial. 我们人生最后的追求是什么？
So what is the thing that we pursue for at the end of our life?
主耶稣说，我去为你们预备地方。
Jesus said that I'm going to prepare a place for you.
然后我要再来。
And I will come back.
我在哪里，我要带你们到那里去。
Wherever I am, I will bring you there.
因此我们最后人生的终点就是回到父那里去。
So at the end of our life, our our pursuit should be going back to our Heavenly Father.
啊，因此我们在地上做寄居做客人，真正的盼望是在天上。
So even though we are living as strangers here on earth, our hope should be in heaven.
好，那雅各对他一生的结论是什么？
So what is Jacob's his own conclusion for his life?
我们看四十八章。
Let's turn to chapter 48.
啊，四十八章的十五节。
Chapter 48, verse 15.15. And he blessed Joseph and said, God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac walked, the God who has fed me all my life long to this day. 16. The angel who has redeemed me from all evil, bless the lads. Let my name be named upon them, and the name of my fathers Abraham and Isaac, and let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth. Here is instructions from Jacob to Joseph.
这里提到，亚伯拉罕，我父以撒所侍奉的神，就是牧养我一生的神。
Here talked about the father, the God of his father Abraham and Isaac is the God who had fed him all his.
这是他，对一生走过。漂泊的一生，寄居的人生的一个结论，就是神牧养他的一生。
And this is the conclusion he has made for his own pilgrimage.
啊，是吧？因为神牧养他一生，所以神救赎他脱一切的患难。
God has fed him and shepherded him his whole life and saved him and redeemed him from all evil.
哦，所以啊，我们从雅各的一生里面学习到。
And so from Jacob's life,
寄居在不同的地方。
We can learn that we might dwell in different places.
但是神要与我们同在。
But God will be with us.
他要牧养我们的一生。
He's going to feed us and guide us.
这个就是我们最重要的，要需要追求的。
And this is the most important thing that we should pursue after.
神的恩典一定会非常的丰盛。
And then we will have abundant grace from God.
我们唱诗。
Let's sing hymns.
234首。
234. In number 234.
我们最后要一起来祷
告。Lastly, we'll kneel down and pray together.
要为全世界这个疫情祷告，求主赏赐平安给所有的人。
And we have to pray for the relief of the pandemic that's occurring in this world right now.
但是从圣经看起来，所有的瘟疫到最后的结论就是因为罪。
And from the Bible, we know that plagues are a result of sin.
所以我们更求神能够感动世人，能够回归转向神。
So in our prayer, we should pray so that God can move the hearts of people, so that people can turn towards.
那在神面前能够谦卑认罪。
That we can all be humble in front of God and to admit our sins.
那神就要赦免我们的罪，要医治我们的地。
And God will forgive us of our sins and heal the land.
我们现在一起来祷告十五分钟。
Now we'll pray for 15 minutes.
那时间到，我就要领。
And when the time is up, I will ring the bell.
我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray together.